Good morning. I am getting ready to go swimming right now, so I'm really excited about that. But I'm going to be sharing about God's power and our weakness. This scripture that I'm going to read is from the TPT translation. It says, "My grace is always more than enough for you, and my power finds its full expression through your weakness. So I will celebrate my weakness. For when I am weak, I sense more deeply the mighty power of Christ living in me. So I'm not defeated by my weakness, but delighted. For when I feel my weakness and endure mistreatment, when I'm surrounded with troubles on every side and face persecution because of my love for Christ, I'm made yet stronger. For my weakness becomes a portal to God's power." Guys, so this is talking about, Paul's thorn, whatever, but you can apply this to your life today because we are weak all the time. We can't do this on our own. The power doesn't come from within us, it comes from God. And in Acts 1:8, it says, "You will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you." This is God's power. So the same scripture that says, your weakness becomes a portal to God's power. That portal that he's talking about, I believe, is the Holy Spirit, because the Holy Spirit is what empowers us and fills us to do these things. Sometimes you don't even know what to pray for, and the Spirit just brings things to mind. Or sometimes you don't know what to say, or you need direction or guidance for the next thing. And that's when the Holy Spirit comes upon you and fills you with that power that this is talking about. And sometimes God's timing, we need God's timing and power to be fully effective. Sometimes God's timing is not, what we expect. You guys already know I was in a season of waiting. I still am right now. But waiting sometimes it is part of his plan, and waiting is a really good thing, because in the waiting is when you learn to depend on God. When you learn to depend on him, that's all he wants from you. He wants dependence on him. Like, he wants you to depend on him for everything that you need. And so during that time, it's hard, but we need to just wait and listen. And waiting doesn't mean sitting doing nothing. That means doing the next thing that he calls you to do, being obedient, and then just trusting, So this scripture in 2 Peter 1:3, I want to end with this because it says that by his divine power, so again, talking about God's power, God has given us everything we need for living a godly life. So I want to focus on how God has given us everything we need. He's given us his power. He shares his divine nature with us. Like, and again, that's through the Holy Spirit. So today, just remember that you can receive power, and when you think you're weak, or when you are weak, that's how God's power will be made perfect in you, his grace. Another translation that says that. So receive that power today. Receive God's power, and he's given you everything that you need to live this life with him. So have a good day.